ESA's Rosetta spacecraft, imagery and issues on your SpacePod for July 12, 2010. We sure do like pretty pictures here at Space Vidcast. The latest stunning imagery comes from our friends over at ESA. The Rosetta spacecraft flew only 3,162 kilometers, or just under 2,000 miles, from the Lutetia asteroid on July 10, 2010. This asteroid is about 130 kilometers in diameter and is the largest asteroid ever to be visited by a spacecraft. Now check out a few of the images that Rosetta took. Notice the heavily cratered surface, much like our own moon. That would come from billions of years of impacts with other objects. To put the size of this asteroid into perspective, it's about 1/13 the size of our moon at 130 kilometers as opposed to 1,737 kilometers for good old Luna. Lutetia is not the final destination for Rosetta, just a little stop along the way. In 2014, the spacecraft should rendezvous with 67P churyumov-gerasimenko, where it will not only orbit the comet, but also place a lander on its surface. Now, like many spacecraft these days, the Rosetta craft has not been without its issues, and the mission is not even done yet. Originally, the craft was to be launched in January 2003 with a rendezvous target of 46P Wirtanen in 2011. However, this plan had to be abandoned after an Ariane 5 rocket failed to launch on time. A new plan was formed to launch in February 2004 with a new target of 67P Churyumov-Gerasimenko. And after two more launch scrubs, which we all know and love, the Rosetta spacecraft finally took flight March 2, 2004. However, this late launch date was not without consequence. On February 25, 2007, the spacecraft had to perform a low-altitude bypass of Mars to correct trajectory due to the later launch date. How low? About 250 kilometers or 155 miles. During this time, the solar panels could not be used as they would be in the shadow of Mars for 15 minutes, which forced engineers to put the craft into standby mode and hope the batteries would last. Of course, the batteries were not designed for this, and it would be a very dangerous shortage of power. This created the nickname the billion-dollar gamble for this particular maneuver. Of course, rocket scientists really do know how to gamble, and the flyby was a smashing success. Now here's hoping Rosetta has a continued safe journey, and we get even more stunning imagery and science from that craft for years to come. Now, Space Geeks, our show doesn't end here. Remember to subscribe to us in iTunes and help make Space Vidcast the number one space-related podcast in the iTunes podcast directory. Leave your comments and let us know what you think. And don't forget to check out our live show this Friday at 0200 hours Coordinated Universal Time, where we'll have guest Dennis Wingo, the author of Moon Rush, joining us. We'll be talking about the moon and how it can be utilized to better life here on Earth. Ever have a friend ask, why should we go back to the moon and on to Mars? Well, Dennis has those answers. For those of you in the U.S., it'll be Thursday night at 7 p.m. Pacific Daylight Time, 8 p.m. Mountain Daylight Time, 9 p.m. Central Daylight Time, or 10 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. You can watch on your computer, iPhone, iPad, Roku box, all live, and we'll see you there. ...67P Churyumov-Gerasimenko, did I say that right? Gerasimenko. Churyumov-Gerasimenko. 67P Churyumov-Gerasimenko. Churyumov-Gerasimenko, just under 2,000 miles from the Lutetia. Now, to put that size of this asteroid into comparison, we sure do like pretty pictures here at Space Vidcast. Now, the latest stunning... On February 25th, 2007, the spacecraft had to perform a low-altitude bypass of Mars to correct...